Hello everyone, I'm sorry I caused all the delays of my vlog of Sonic the Hedgehog 4. I'm not gonna use a camera to do that, I decided to use the microphone. But anyway, sorry for all the delays, so I gotta go with the negatives and the positives of Sonic the Hedgehog 4. So, I gotta start with that. I actually like this game, but it's actually rehashed from the old games, like the Splash Hill Zone was like Green Hill Zone, and Emerald Hill Zone, and Palm Tree Panic from Sonic CD. And Casino Night was, well, like Casino Night, except Carnival Night and Spring Yard Zone. Lost Labyrinth was like Labyrinth Zone from Sonic 1, but the Mad Gear Zone was like Metropolis. It was not like Scrap Brain Zone, but the Egg Station was like Death Egg Zone from Sonic 1, but it actually has some renovations done in that game. So anyway, the leaderboards was actually one of the useless things I've ever seen. I mean, it doesn't make a repeated play replay value for me, but the replay value was actually the 7 Chaos Emeralds and unlocking Supersonic. And yes, Supersonic makes a return. Wow. That's actually disappointing that in the Sonic Advance series on the Game Boy Advance, he didn't make a playable. But I gotta say, the physics are not that screwed up. It actually doesn't have flow, but it actually has the momentum-based platforming. And let me tell you that I really hate that Sonic the Hedgehog 4 is episodic release from 1, 2, and 3. And I want Super Peel Up Move and those unused music from the 90s Sonic games, including the I want those canceled ones also. And of course, some of the new musics. And of course, bring back the Super Peel Up from Sonic CD. I just love that Super Peel Up. You press up and you hold the jump button. Okay, so I can't believe there's everywhere speed boosters. They're all over the place, including the springs. Jeez. What the hell? Yeah, actually, well, some of the bosses are really easy, but some of them are a fair challenge. And the final boss is absolutely one of the hardest ones I've ever seen. It's actually the boss from Sonic 2 with some new tricks in it, like electricity as a shield around the robot, and it shoots also projectiles. And of course, yeah, when he does the final attack, you have to hit the jump button at the precise moment when he lands, and then use the homing attack, and bam, he explodes. Casino Night was absolutely, well, nice, because it does have card gimmicks. I love the card gimmicks in that. And the zip lines were absolutely awesome on Splash Hill Zone. And, well, one of my personal favorite I don't know what I'm going to say about this. But I really hate the special stages in the game, because you have to just use the D-pad or the Wiimote. Oh yeah, I only own the Wii version, because the Wii points are cheaper than Xbox, the Microsoft points. The reason I hate special stages is because there's too much all over the place, those bumpers. The most part of the controls works well, but I recommend you use the D-pad, not the Wiimote itself. The controls are absolute broken as hell. And let me tell you, I really don't want to see any more bumpers, and I can't wait to see Tails and Knuckles appear on the future episodes. And you know what? I also want Espio. Espio never got rejected, so I want this character return. Ninja always win, bitch. I think that was on Wiz Wars. Well, one of his, Random Crap Kirby made epic. Oh yeah, speaking of that, I played Sonic Fan Remix. I really still hate it. Ugh. It looks butchered version of... It makes... Really... I don't know. Well, it looks like a butchered version of Sonic the Hedgehog 2. And this is my opinion, not yours. And you can't change my opinion. So, what else? Oh, yeah. I gotta say, it looks absolutely admirable. This game, the Sonic the Hedgehog 4. It looks identical to the HD version, but the music sounds a bit different from the HD counterparts and the iPhone. Oh yeah. The overworld map is exclusively on the console, but the iPhone gets a menu option. So, I gotta say, this is actually really good, but I can't wait to try Sonic Colors for the Wii and DS. So, I think that game is going to be better than Sonic 4. And don't get me wrong, Sonic 4 is still fun to play, but some of you fans hated it, and some of you fans like it. Like me, I actually love it, but actually, I can't wait for Sonic 4 Episode 2 to come out. And you know what? I also forgot to say, Sega, bring back anything we love. Bring back SPO, bring back the Super Emerald, the Master Emerald, and of course, well, the Super PL from Sonic CD, and of course some of the Badniks from Sonic CD, and also that one Badnik that was not used in the final version in Sonic 1 and 3. So please, bring them back. So, I can't wait for Sonic Colors to come out in November 12th. So, that's all I have to say. So, stay tuned for more of my favorite Tales of Symphonia, Dawn of the New World. Oh, and I think I might make a Let's Play, like... No More Heroes. Later, guys.